the text here, I think, really to try and help out his teammates and support from the garden
30
side.
30 seconds left. Spike down A.
And X-Side aren't exactly fighting all too much in terms of utility, taking real solo towards Cat and Tex in a great position to try to wrap on. Weeded takes him down, jumping away. Speaking of jumping, you, oh man, hopping away, just trying to get anything out of this interaction. But with a Nebula covering up A main, Dabs is completely isolated. He has a little bit of armor. The spike is planted for him, but it's trying to make a little bit of noise too. This could bait out a bit of a fake, and there you go. The mid attention is actually gone. Because of that one spot, now Android, not only able to take up more space and spawn, but they're able to make their way into market fairly easily. Still Aaron and BCJ collecting up frags, but this could be the spike going down. Finally, BCJ with a swing out, going to be able to take down EU. Plank going in, BCJ doesn't shut it down.
But a lurk from Tex will at least give them an advantage for this post plant.
Well, he's still going, Aaron. Oh,
wow.
Aaron goes down to Daps. So the three players that make their way onto A, they leave two isolated, and the two isolated players, they do their job. Then comes the rest of Xset that could just get pinched down out of nowhere. The Spectre does get a little bit more damage, and Pure.
Pure to go huge here.
Oh no, Pure. The slow peak, and it's just a slow burn. Goes down, and well, Yeah, that's a little bit awkward. Daps was just in that position for the longest time, and his utility wasn't exactly spotted whatsoever. DCJ gonna go down and
catch. And those are always something that you can use to leverage in a round like this, and well, they're gonna try and get aggressive and ensure that the ult can't be used, as already so much focus here with a run it back committed as well from Weeded towards B-Lane.
Okay, this is beautiful. Pure coming in from the mid side. We'd actually criticize one player for doing this. Just is that? With the nano swarm elevated, I actually don't know where he at. Android still has a run it back. Don't really think it's gonna come into too much effect just a little bit later on. But yeah, there goes that turret, and they were waiting for it. Yeah, wonderfully. The fake lockdown. So much util is gonna be used. Okay, BCJ using up that Hunter's Fury is comboed up onto Android. But this, oh, there you go. That was the battle to separate the round. We were looking over towards Amy. Never mind. It's a battle for the A set again, though. Look at what he did. Isolated, facing up against Psalm, Psalm, Psalm. Sticking. Okay, he's sticking. No, it's just Psalm still in that 1v2. We did goes around the corner, gets the body shot. Okay, so not that big of a situation. Take a minute. Yes, they are.
That's the whole point.
Yes, they are. Oh, yeah, no, absolutely it is. So Thwifo, he can commit up that Hunter, not Hunter's Fury. He can commit down that lockdown. EU's gonna pull out the Hunter's Fury more than likely. And there you go. Tex over towards the mid side, going big, misses out on the second round of knives, and backs out with the Spectre, still trying to take down Pure. Pure at 50 HP, and he goes down in a heap to the 14 HP Tex. BCJ and Aaron, last two remaining, fighting up in chat. They swap positions to the Cosmic Divide.
Still those knives to work with for Pure. We'll see what entrance he can make. No dash, but BCJ will find himself an opening.
Oh, okay, Pure and BCJ finding the openings. Like you mentioned, Android's still in the back line. They have no clue just yet. He's cut off noise. But EU still collecting up two frags, and it was looking possible until Weeded holds down the courtyard area.
Around this mid area, and Aaron must win this fight. The timing, not for Android, puts it back to a 4v4.
A little tough for Android. He was in a great spot earlier on towards stairs, but in we go and towards B site. We did playing up in stairs. There's nobody on site just yet for the CTs. There's still one in the corner, right in the middle of their own cloud, and BCJ gets overwhelmed by the nano swarm. Tex backing up, sliding and getting to. And now Aaron is still trying to attempt a couple of exits. Could take down Dabs. Wait a minute. No, he's done. Yeah, just straight committing to this. He takes over complete advantage of Market and Aaron. I was about to say, he still has a lot of potential with those stars right next to him.
Oh,
and Aaron.
Oh!
Wonderfully done from Aaron. And he's still going for more. Aaron, it doesn't need to be a Star Ward. He just has a rifle and the firepower works. Almost like a laser in his pocket. Towards A. Oh my, it's gonna be a little bit strong from Psalm at least. Has to get more than one. And Daps in the back line has all that util covering up Cat, but nobody cares. Pure just keeps holding down W and makes his way on. There goes that nano swarm covering up the heaven side. So many drops. Thwifo gonna be able to get one off the nano swarm. Aaron with another one. Texas now the last one remaining in a 1v2. Okay, Daps. Trying to go in, and now there's three people here. Look at that Nebula! No, nobody knows that he's here! Nobody knows that Android is just chilling! Now in comes the kills! There you go! The Nebula gonna dissipate! Android gonna be able to get one! Still have to get the kill onto Pure, and oh, wow. That could have been... Oh, you doubt. I'm excited for it. I'm excited. Let's see, BCJ. Let's see it, baby. Still... there's still a couple more moves to actually make your way through. There's multiple rifles, and BCJ tries to take the long way of it. Exit. It was just... Okay, Pure. Nice little schmovement there. Still getting the kill. I was about to say exit. It was just triumphant. They're gonna go down in a heap, and there goes the knives. The frenzy goes out, immediately takes down Tex, but still. There you go. We did going in, still might run into one right through the Nebula. There goes that running back, curveball in. We did still trying to find
the body.
To
kill the body. Oh,
hold it! No, his running back expires before Android. So Android still gets a kill with the Pure, and he's fine in the back line. So a little bit awkward. 13 seconds left. Spike will be able to go down. And Android still approaching, making a couple of footsteps. There's still one in logs. He gets the kill immediately. Daps now the last one remaining. Aaron still has a couple of stars too, if I'm not mistaken. Can just plug up Daps in this area. No, he's pretty much done. He's just looking for exits potentially. Just take it one by one. Okay, there you go. Yep, take it one by one, Daps. What's down the turret? Still two in that back line. Double swing from exit. Oh. Headshot from Daps. Oh. That could have been it. Trying to hold it down, calling out for a rotation. Has that recon bolt in, and Pure takes him down. Three more players remaining for NRG off the retake. Oh. Make that only two. And yeah, that's pretty much it. BCJ just holding it down. Tex with that off, he's got to run.
Slips through. He's chilling. I don't know if he's gonna be able to get away scot-free. Spike, can they get the op out of his hands for boss for the last round? No.
Here we go again. We did around the corner. Oh, the quick scope, not gonna happen.
Towards B main, who comes out on top?
We did still fighting. Gets up that first pick. Android up close and personal with that curveball, and there you go. The utilization. Daps actually wants to hug the corner. There's no flashes, so Thwipa just goes out dry right into the cold hands of Daps. And this time wasting is just allowing the rotation to go in slowly but surely. And Weeded goes out right as Android. Any moves towards this site, NRG, the only thing that they can do is wait. Exit. This is such a tight battle. At any moment, things could just get so dicey. They're playing crossfires, and it just doesn't work at all. EU with a short burst, right onto Weeded. Although making space, Weeded just jumps right through. Like there's nobody even there. EU, however, takes back a kill over in heaven. Tex, look at the speed on him. He's trying to wrap all the way back into A main, and he could come in at such an opportune time.
He's going to get spotted by this turret, though, and as soon as the turret goes off, you have a swarm, but that's going to divert their attention, and it makes a tiny opening.
But he's still chilling. All right, finally he takes down the turret, so he has to go out. Android dropping right into his own hot hands. Tex getting a kill with the BCJ. These last two players are stuck in hell! Cooped up together! Android shuts it down with it. And now, Nanoswarm hitting the back, recon bolt in the middle of sight, right off of a pick early on from Saul, and he gets himself a second, instantly traded back by Pure. Still two over towards that heaven area. Tex can be a hero here. Still playing pivot, couple of players dropping by BCJ. Spotted out, back into A main.
Yeah.
As he does have that Hunter's Fury.
I was going to say, he also has double shock darts. So you need to delay this in the lockdown. That's going to bait out the Hunter's Fury, so now they've only got shock darts.
Whoa, Daps! He walks right through! He walks through the Hunter's Fury! He uses the Hunter's Fury as sort of like a smoke! Wow! Exet immediately in retaliation to that Owl Drone. They just make their way out, and the Cosmic Divide going up. Android EU holding it down. Android still has short! What an angle from Android! Getting the headshot onto Aaron from the floor. BCJ 1v5 goes down! Flawless is the name of the game! At least that Owl Drone, a couple of players coming over towards Cats. You still have one in A main. And this is just way too tough. Exet is taking this slow, but off this pop, Energy has such good positions to work with. But there you go. They don't even need to pop. Thwipe on BCJ, all getting kills. We did stacking up too. Now it's all Daps. Daps Still has 150. Goes right through the hot hands. Has to take down Weeded. Weeded down to a... This half. Out of just the attacking side alone. Let's see if they can bring back that fire. Dex! Oh, baby! Getting three! BCJ and Thwifu now remaining. Here you go. Rifles out. Daps in a cheeky angle. Doesn't take down both. BCJ taking on a little bit of noise over towards B, but this is actually dragging out attention. Three players here on the B side. It's going to come down to two on A, and there you go. NRG have broken through, taking down at least two, but you still have Thwifu. Thwifu in a good angle. Able to take down 28. Oh, still just a little bit of util. It's mainly for that post plant. Thwifu is still on site. Can he get more? He certainly can. Thwifu with a third in the lockdown. Why not just launch it? Daps has to fight this. He has to get the plant. No, yeah. Wait, whoa. It's a one.
What?
The 1v1 out of nowhere in Daps.
You see, the gate has been opened. Who knows what awaits on the other side? Is Thwifu great opening?
Thwifu, big one. Silence. It's our first man advantage in a while, but it still could get exposed. EU and Song, Android in a wonderful position, could shut it all down for map one. Great, the odds are against them. NRG maintaining at least two over towards that A side. It's that same KJ Astra combo.
Yeah, well, there's only one player here though. Spot one out towards mid. I'll give them the info that he's run back towards A, which. The idea that he's running back to some of his teammates, but in reality,
bracket that would be. It's already starting to heat up more and more. Oh my god! What just happened there? Of course, that guiding light ended up going over towards the mid side, but man, just the fact that they just end up walking right into three players, four players, trying to rotate back to B, ends up giving them a massive gift. They take down two players. So Aaron, how does Aaron even get on the? That's almost full HP, 31 on Android, and that's it. Anarch. And that's the anticipation for a lot of these players. Vine being a little bit more of an extensive map in terms of firepower, so we could see those, could see that off. But this side, it's only Android.
Oh, look at this swing with that deep smoke. They can take this TP, and wow, that is a huge gamble in Tex. Looking for an early fight. It's just a crunch in the showers, and man, they are bathing. NRG quickly sweeping things up. Yeah, the spike is gonna go down.
Going out very early. Zom just holding on to the brunt of the damage. The Reef Calm Bolt goes in. The spike will be able to get defused. I think, yes, it will. Although it's on the open. Lots of kills going back and forth. Beast.
Back, never mind. Leaning back here is gonna be NRG.
Look at this.
Here to try and open that.
No way.
The showstopper, it goes the other way. Can they get the trade? Yes, they can.
Yeah, but there's still two in hookah, and they have no clue that there's two in hookah. Som, able to get two out of this. BCJ with a flank up in mid. And again, they have no information that there's two in hookah. Now they finally do. Tex finally goes down, and Aaron holding it down. Aaron with a 3K. Side recon bolt to try to clear out the back of sight. You still have Android in a pretty good spot. He could just get flanked up by multiple players, and indeed he does. We did end up getting the kill. Cosmic Divide still up. EU with 100 Fury nailing through, getting a whole lot of pings. So Daps playing around, and the Seekers chasing him down, so they know that Daps is just around this green box. The turret finds one. We did off the off angle. Daps only has 35 HP. How does he win that against BCJ? Finally, the lockdown isolates most of the NRG players, but look at this position from Tex. Fight Tex as we go through. No shot! Wow! He actually does go for it, and he does win. Spike now in his control. 20 seconds left. EU not making any noise whatsoever. If Aaron wants to turn back, he could just get flanked on, and EU... We did still has a guiding light to potentially get a little bit of that information, but again, it's gonna have to come down to all of this utility. If Daps can stay alive! But there you go. That's the linchpin gone, essentially, in terms of that hold. Now it's just EU, meaning now in a 1-on-4, holding it back. Gets the kill up front and center right onto Aaron, but BCJ takes it back. That's the B side, all theirs. But no, it's not all theirs. There's two players just walking out. And there you go. They combine. Yet, and nobody peeking, period. Wifo thinks that he's safe. But look at the crossfire. Som sitting over towards Long. Oh, my NRG. Setting up four here on side already. An exit. Almost just get completely denied over towards bathroom. And the spike carrier in terms of BCJ goes down from the elevated area where Som is sitting. Yeah, oh, this shock dart actually takes down Weed. That was full contact. Goes down. Two players still for exit on the other side of the map. And look at the amount of util on B still.
Yeah, I mean, Good heavens. Daps can just throw the lockdown whenever he pleases. He's got that elbow control. He's got sight control in the form of that swarm and alarm bot. It's going to take time to clear. It's going to take time for them to get the spike down. And yeah, delay, delay, delay. Lockdown in effect. What do you do here for your X set?
Okay, gravity. Well, but Daps wins it. Lockdown be lockdown. They're not even get the spike. They're not even going to get the spike done to really make that lockdown be lockdown worth it. And
two.
What? What? What just happened? Did they confuse their own lockdown? They just confused their own lockdown for their opponent's lockdown. I love this versatility. I love just this inch decision making. And Pure! Oh my god! The combo that we've been waiting for! Gravity Well!
That chance is starting to slip as the info's revealed. We did. Oh, he's able to transition from one, but they know where he is. Can't gun down the second.
Wipo still on U-Haul. Aaron needs this kill! But both players! Okay, no, never mind. Thwipo's still alive. Thwipo's still alive. Trying to take down Android. Saw him just going for the defuse. Takes on a headshot, but that is it. Double digits for NRG before the half even ends.
This is out.
You know, I'm not going to say impossible. I'm going to say more improbable. But yeah, we still have another round on our hands. Tex trying to go big here. Covered up with one of the Seekers. BCG trying to go a big with a Judge. And Tex, who stayed alive in the corner, finally pops out with an updraft alongside his knives. And just like that, X sets the plethora of frags going back with a Judge. Well, they're making it work. Now look at this crossfire. It's very similar to what NRG played against one of the X-Set players just a little bit ago. One over towards Tin Can, and it's that same setup. Daps puts down a turret. And look at this peek. And there you go. Aaron could have taken him down. Thwipo could have taken him down. 12 to 10. X-Set, oh my god. I was about to say, X-Set need an explosive start to this half to really make things worth it. And look at this. Every single body for X-Set except for one stacked up in short.
Oh.
And it's Weeded. You only need Weeded, really. Fragging out, catching two. Some around the corner looking to farm. Going to be able to get one, but no more than one. Last two players remaining now. Daps and Tex. Stomping up into short from the mid side. Your teammate Thwipo hasn't spotted anything long either, hasn't heard anything. The Owl Drone gonna be able to catch one. Thwipo TP's in, and they can't get the spike. It's a no man's land.
Hold on. No one's looking Daps this way. No one is looking Daps this way. No, he needs to clear this corner.
No.
There they go. No, Daps.
No way.
Checks one corner and he has a chance, but nothing. Nothing at all. It will be a 30th for X at Texas. Messing around. If he's able to get a kill, you know, it's at least a charge to the ult, but no way Jose he's gonna pull that off. He's not gonna be able to do that. He has to support his team in Hookah.
Right, and they know the danger. They know that there's players already on the B site too, and there you go. Tex just takes down Aaron as he just bursts through the nebula.
Thwipo.
And Thwipo is still going! Thwipo holding down the line with a vice grip. I love how he's being chased and he's still just holding W, trying to fight up the mid side. Very valiant, to say the least. Still two players remaining now. For NRG, Tex and Somm. Coupled up with a crossfire right into the defensive side. And wow, BCJ, we did combine. Potentially so. X-Set just need to maintain things real clean. But Tex, wow, okay. You actually hate to see that. He just rolls right in the middle of a two-man crossfire. I'm glad we noticed that at the same time. Did NRG just get 3 kills in the matter of like 2 seconds?
Yeah, it feels like that. And now that they've got guns, or probably just now that one of them's got a gun, they've got a swarm, 2 shock darts to maybe play this post plant. But no, they're getting aggressive here. Lockdown to the back. That might force EU's Daps! What?
And lockdown! Lock it down, Daps! Lock it down! Thwipo now remaining in a 1v2. They're not even using it yet. They don't even want to use it.
They're
just
laying
short. They're baiting Thwipo. They're baiting Thwipo. Thwipo, check the angle. EU's still in the back. Alarm bot is there. There it goes. There it goes. Recon in. Recon in. EU shuts it down. It's a thrifty round. NRG.
Showstopper forcing them into showers. But now they've got to readjust. Tex is leaping out here with a blade storm.
Yeah, this is great early control from NRG. They spot out the pressure over towards short, and they just explode. Tex, go for it, baby! 3 players right in front of him as he emerges from the nebula, but he's only able to get one from it. And Somm still stacking.
He knows he needs to create a fight here. a must-win, and he's been presented the opportunity with this Hunter's Fury. Nothing is really connecting right now. BCJ in a 1v2. If there's one man you wanted to clutch Rex, it has to be him.
No shot, right? Again, NRG is doing it.
Another eco.
BCJ, however, can shut down that sentiment. And it's yet another eco post-plant where the last two players, they opt to play very, very safe. Back into elbow.
He's not looking.
No, not looking at all. BCJ finally committing some
through the B area, so they're not committed to this rotation just yet. They need to keep at least someone here. Third coming in. Swarm is out. Pierre's got a gap, and Pierre needed to go huge. He's only good for one. Sight given up, but BCJ's here at least.
BCJ making a lot of noise, and the Showstopper doesn't even need to be expended to take down BCJ. Instead now, Android nails Thwifo! 1v4, we did! Can he do it all? Pulled at the Seekers a little bit earlier on, but nothing can help him now. Other than himself, takes down one, still has one in heaven to try to cover up. Peek from Android, not exactly going in just yet, and Tex!
Does the streak break here?
It's been a long road. It's funny, we mentioned that every single game for Xset and NRG.